Hello everybody, and welcome to another live stream. This time we're doing a Let's Play of Breath of Fire 2. So, let's get into it. And Dagger is adding her input. Yes. And just like the original game, this menu will look very familiar. However, this intro will be a lot different. So this game takes, hang on one second. There we go. Dagger down. Okay. This game takes place several years after the first one. Ow. Alright, I'll go look for her because I don't want to get punched in the face again. So I should move my mouse cursor out of the way. And yes, Dagger is with me trying to add her own commentary. Aren't you? Fine. Go into random people's houses and steal their herbs. Quote unquote herbs. Apparently not, because she ran away on me. Yeah, Dagger's my cat. And I have Cloak sitting right next to me. Do not adjust your color, because this game actually does start in black and white. So, this is the battle menu for Breath of Fire 2. It got a big revamp from the first one. Music sounds a lot better, too. Yeah, sure. Just give me the EXP. Sure, let's close our eyes. That's not your mother. Nope, anyways. It does go quiet for this part too, so do not worry. The music will return. Well, so let's take a look at our stats. Huh. Eh, not too bad. Oh, hey, everything's in color again. Wait, what? Whoops. Yep, the village now no longer remembers you. Father Hulk, the Hulkinator. The heck is going on here? It says that Bao joined the party, but Spooky Dungeon. Famous last words. Let's follow what's causing the noise. Oh boy. Something tells me I'm not going to be able to win this fight. Nope. Talk about overkill. So this is a great intro compared to Breath of Fire 1. This intro is really good. Ten years later. Thank you. You gotta be pretty stupid to lose a pet. All right. This game, it does have a few flaws. But, nothing too bad. So there is a glitch in this game where you can actually get a lot of money. But I'm not gonna do that because it takes too much time. I'm good now. Few upgrades for everybody's equipment. And here's a good, so the shop system and the item management systems both got overhauled. So now you can buy items in bulk. So for an example, if you wanted to buy a full stack of 9 herbs, you can. Most of the items can be bought like in multiples of 1 to 9. If you go into the item menu, oh hey look, there's a cleanup button. Well, that makes everything convenient. Oh, hey, you can order it by yourself. You can trash, use. Oh, hey, look, there's even a special section for your key items. And your items, your item bag has a lot more space. And I mean a lot. You don't really run into item management issues like you did in the previous game. Alright, now then. Alright. Time to go find someone's pet. And now we can actually start winning battles. So, all the characters in Breath of Fire 2 got overhauled as well. They're using much nicer sprites. The battle system is still somewhat isometric. but now each character has their own special command. So Ryu's Guts command allows him to recover his own HP every now and then. If you use it too much during a battle, it will fail, and the amount that is recovered, it increases as you level up. Bao's Shock command can either do a one-hit KO, or it can just do one damage. So let's see how well things go. So with Bao's Shock command, it'll do exactly the monster's HP when it succeeds. And you also notice new enemies, they have a question mark for a life gauge. That I do like. I do like that because it lets you explore the monsters a little bit. Yeah, why not? Oh, right. No money. Okay. Whatever. Let's do the time warp again. So, just like in Breath of Fire 1, this game also has a day-night cycle. And Ryu has the ability to change time. And also, no fanfare when you level up. Thank God. Also, too, you can see when you're about to level up. Also, some characters have field abilities. Ah. So, Bao can actually hunt with his crossbow, which is nice. That's the worst part of the hunting game, is that Bao is really slow to get his shot off. So this is a good spot to level up, because you're right there beside a... Whoa, holy shit. So yeah, you are right beside a healing spring where you can actually, you know, heal. Oh good, I got a lead off attack. Really? You're just gonna run away. Okay. No. Actually, I didn't really lose that much. Yeah, I only had 30 coins on me, so... Again, when you lose... When you, get a game over, you lose half your money, so... Actually, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna put them back in the normal position. And yeah, you actually have different formations for your party, which is great. But yeah, the encounter rate is still pretty high, but it's actually not that bad. Alright, so now we get to use... Alright, time to grind up a bit. Great. Thank you. But yeah, grinding can be a pain, but it's an evil necessity. Yep, fighting leeches and spiders. That's how you want to start your adventure. Well, at least we're about to level up again. So that's always a good start. And of course we get poisoned right off the bat. What is this, a Pokemon game? So, Bao is actually the main healer of the group, and in this game they actually fixed a lot of the spells so that they're not using set damage, they actually range. However, healing spells still do a set amount of healing. Which is great for Bao, whose magic attack is kind of meh. But at the same time, when you have healing items, and you can get them going a lot faster, a lot of the healing spells don't really work out too much. Plus, it really makes no sense that Bao learns all of his, like, single-target healing moves before he'll learn his multi-target healing moves. Like, for an example, Cure 3 heals the entire party for 120 HP, but he'll learn Cure 4 before he learns Cure 3. So it's like, well, what's the point, right? I mean, for a portly doggo, Bao is actually quite agile, too. So, I mean, with Ryu, he's pretty well-rounded. With Bao, yeah, he's got good strength. I want to get to the point where I can one-shot most of the enemies here, or at least outspeed them. But yeah, it doesn't, there we go. But yeah, with this game, a lot of the characters are more diverse, especially in their skills. Just give me one second here. There we go. Oh, good, these guys. At least now I can handle them. Alrighty, let's keep going. I guess. Right now? No, but I'm kind of in the middle of something. Well, what's wrong with it? Okay. I'll take a look at it. I'll take a look at it. Bye. All right. Bye. Ugh. Gotta go play tech support again with the parents. All right. One second, I gotta go play tech support with the folks. Hopefully I won't be too long. Thank you. Oh, come on. Okay, I am back. I am done playing tech support for my parents. I'll probably end up cutting that part out. Yeah, it just ended up being an issue with their TV. Oh, hey, they dropped an antidote. Sweet. And the item names are not as cryptic as they were in the first one. Like I said, the encounter rate is still pretty high. At this point, I'm better off using items. Hey, free antidotes. First boss of the game, and it's a trio of harpies. And they all attack each other. The good thing about this boss battle is that you know how they're going to act. So they aren't going to attack, they're not going to attack Bao unless he's the only other person. Thank you. Yep, we just caused a landslide. I mean, the high encounter rate kind of makes up for how you need insane amounts of EXP. But yeah, the small goblins are pretty cute. Too bad I have to kill them. Yeah. We're wearing salad bowls over our heads to protect us. There's a lot of joke equipment items in this game as well. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be a type of helmet, but I like to imagine that they're wearing literal salad bowls over their heads. So, I mean, yeah, could be funny. Hey, it's your favorite small goblins. They're biting my ankles. Good thing is, we have the ability to save. Because there's a two-part fight. So, you can actually use your fire rock here. And I think you can get rid of them in one shot, but I'm gonna hold on to that. When did we have to become pest control? Okay. Boss battle number two, and this time it's against a big roach. I'll give you guys the leg. Ah, little piggy. Let's take off this bothersome collar and boil you. Oh, we almost boiled her pet. Yeah, we almost boiled her pet. And then we stuff it into a bag. So, you notice that little goblin up on the top of the menu there? So that's your monster indicator. That determines how many monsters are in the area and how strong they are. You can actually go into an area and keep fighting until there's none left. I think the only place, the only place that does not allow you to, run out of monsters is the world map. Oh. After all those battles, we've accumulated quite a bit of money. Oh, hey, there's the fish guy. Yeah, sorry I almost buried you in rubble. Did you bathe her? Well, something like that. Thank you. Uh-oh. Something's afoot. Well then, we better head back to the house and see what's going on. I got a garbage can bouncing behind me, so let's go. Actually, I should do a save state here, because some of the dialogue here is quite hilarious. I want... Comic books? What? Comic books? Oh, and you're going to throw it away? Will you tell me where you threw it away later? There's no real reason. Watch me narc on him. All right, cool. Thank you. Alrighty. Man, the goblins are always running away really quickly. Yeah, it's true. I gotta go experience the plot. I like this theme for some reason. Yeah, it really does. Time to take a jaunt over to the next town. Man, I need like 300 EXP to gain a level now. Oh man, these things I hate with a passion. And there it is. Yeah, cure all. No, I'm still good for that. Four, three, two. Right. All right, so so I think I'm going to end things here and save my game. And when we pick up next time, we will be going into Tag Woods to have a little chat with the Axe Fighter Baba. Anyways, thank you all for coming out. I'll see you in the next one.